Dear teachers and students, welcome to our section number three, online tools. And in this video, we are going to talk about next line tool, which might be very useful for you while organizing your online activities, and it's called Calendly. So Calendly is your scheduling automation platform for eliminating the hassle of back and forth emails or finding the perfect time and many more activities. Today we are going to talk about how you can create this special Calendly and schedule your event and put different settings for this activity. This application is might be used as a free version, but you can also upgrade and pay some amount of money. But actually, it's pretty enough for teachers to use the free version of this application. So what do you need to know and what do you need to do when you create Calendly activities here? So first of all, remember that this is platform which is connected with your calendar. So you can schedule events here, and when you're busy enough and you have many students, but at the same time you need to organize a lot of individual meetings with them. So Calendly is a great choice, and this is what you need for your online meetings. So to create a new event or a new type of meetings, you need to use the button which is called New Event Type, and it's mentioned with plus. So you just press this button and you can see all the type of these events which might be useful for you. So first of all, one-on-one meeting or one-on-one event. When you create this event, it lets an invitee pick a time to meet with you. So you just create an event. You share the link with the people, with the different amount of people you are going to work with, and each of this pe person. Which of these people will choose only one slot of the time, and after that, their link for this person will be closed. Yes, so it's only one option when you send the link to, let's say, 10 people, and each of them will have only one chance to choose like different type. And after that, there is no chance to change this time or to delete the event. But you can reschedule, of course, this time if necessary. The next activity, the next type of event, it is called group. So when you have group and you're not going to communicate with person one-on-one, but you would like the whole group choose as many possible options or slots as possible. So you just let multiple invitees meet with you at one time. So you propose different slots of time, different available time which you have, and the group will choose, will vote for those slots, and after that you can decide which time is the most suitable for you and fits your activities. Number three is collective. So you can host an event with another person and let invitees pick a time when you are all available. And the last one, round robin. So you create an event that cycles between multiple hosts. So the most popular activity, the most popular type of event is, of course, the first one, when you have one-on-one meeting and when you let an invitee pick a time to meet with you. This is event is very popular when you need to create individual meetings. So think twice before choosing between these events. So if you need to work with group, please choose the second one option. If you need to work one-on-one with a student or with a teacher or with a colleague or with a trainer, please take a look at the first one. So we will try to create one-on-one event. And to do this, you need just press the button create, And after that, you will have a great list of options and things which you might to complete before this event will be available. So you can give special color to this event and even location if necessary. So don't forget about name, event name. So for example, we can say that's like just like meeting of teachers. And that's it, but you can change it. It's like up to you what name of the event it's going to be. You can use location. So, and here you can see a lot of different options which might be necessary and useful for you. So not only just Zoom, yeah, or Google Meet, but you can also add here phone call. You can set in-person meeting and just write down the name or address or a name of a place. But again, you can also add Microsoft Teams web conference, WebEx, GoToMeeting, leave customized location details. So you don't know where the event will take place yet, but so you will just leave this place, this space like this without any comments, and you will upgrade it a bit later and ask invitee. So where is the best place for them to set the location? Maybe it's going to be like in person, or they prefer to choose to use Zoom, or maybe some of them would like to join via Meet, Google Meet, or Microsoft Teams. When you choose their location, you can next step, you will write description or short instruction of this event. So if it's necessary, of course, you will note what you're going to do during this event, especially if this meeting might be not a surprise, but maybe unusual for your auditory, for your students, for your colleagues. So don't forget to write some summary or some necessary details of this event. If it's necessary to add any links here, so please use the button with link, and you can add these links here without any problems. And after that, you will see the event link. So event link, it is special Calendly event link, which you will share, which you will use and share with your students or teachers or other people you would like to invite. So to complete this page and to have like finally this event link, we need to add like all this information. Of course, there is some like necessary information you must add, of course, and some information is not necessary, but still we will just like use randomly Google Meet. We're going to write any description, yeah, because it's not necessary here, but the event link you see, it will look like this, and it will contain the name of the meeting, which we wrote here previously, meeting of teachers. So after that, you can choose again color if it's necessary to you, if it's important to you. If you have like many meetings, you can create and choose different colors and just put the button next. And here is the page with the most important setting. So this is the place where you can set a range of dates when you can accept meetings using your calendar, when people can book this event, 30 minutes, 60 rolling calendar days, and so on. It's up to you, so you can just like do it according to your calendar. With different dates and different times, you can define how long your event will be, and it can be as long as 12 hours. So if it's like a global event, like something huge you're going to organize, it's possible to write down or choose the number of hours, but not many than 12 hours. Usually the duration of meetings like 30 to 60 minutes, or you can choose custom and you are not going to mention the duration of this meeting. How do you want to offer your availability for this event? So use an existing schedule or set custom hours. It's up to you. So you can select one of your schedules or define custom hours specific to this type of event. And next point is which schedule do you want to use? Working hours, it's like the only option when you will be available. Of course, you will see here the time which will appear when your invitees will be invited to this activity, to this event. And according to your calendar, you will see your weekly hours, your working hours, when you are available or not available. So you can randomly update and upgrade this Calendly and put only those dates which you would like to invite or propose to your auditory, to your students and to your teachers or colleagues. Want to add time before or after your events? So you can also like put a tick here before event and after event and so on. And this is it actually. So the next step will propose you to upgrade your subscription to get unlimited event types, but you can just use free version of this Calendly application and use with your activities here. And this is it. So when you are back to your homepage, you will see the new event which appeared here. So you need to turn it on. And after that, you can share the link with your students or teachers just via your email. Each of the people, each of the your auditory of your students will get this link. And once again, it's very important to remember they will have the chance to choose one option among all of these available slots. But if it happens that they need to reschedule, yeah, to change something, or they forgot that they will be easy at this period of time or on this day, so you can, they can just use the link which appears, which will come to their email and reschedule their time of their future meetings. This is a possible option, and it's very helpful, especially when your timetable is very busy. So there is no problem to change it or write down to your organizer or teacher to notify that you have some problems and tell about that you need to find another slot for your activity. But again, after that, if someone decides to change the time of the activity, change the time of meeting, the number of slots will be not so many, because it depends on the amount of your students, on the number of your students. If you have many students, they will quickly choose available dates which are the most suitable for them. And if you want to change something after that, yes, so the number of these slots will be, of course, not so many as it was before. So I hope this Calendly application will be helpful for you while organizing your online events, especially one-on-one meetings, or if you need to organize one event for big group and you don't know what time to choose and what might be useful and what might be available for them. So please use this Calendly, and if you have any questions, you can contact us and find our information and our emails in the description of this course. Thank you for your attention and enjoy your new application.